Distinguished personalities, organizer of the program, and all participants, good afternoon. Ms. Shiva Hari Sapkota, Joint Secretary, MoPIT. In Nepal, if we talk about the national road network, we have nearly 15,000 kilometers of roads. It is in different provinces I have mentioned here, and other roads in province and local, nearly 100,000 kilometers we have already constructed. Out of this nearly 15,000 kilometer, only 7,000 kilometer roads are blacktopped, and other are earthen and black gravel road. 500 kilometer under construction and 3,000 kilometer under plan. The population influence is 2,370% per kilometer of roads, and the road density is 7.58 kilometer per 100 kilometer square. It is we are taken from the national highway. Length. The historical trend already Bhushanji mentioned this trend of the vehicle registration. The domination of registration is two-wheelers. Nearly about 80% of the weightage goes to two-wheelers. So it is already mentioned by Bhushanji. Yes, it is mentioned the weightage of all types of vehicles registered in Nepal. Very little in public buses, then minibus, mini truck, all these are very, very minimum, but only we have traffic in motorcycle. Nearly 80% registration is two-wheelers. Now I want to mention here, and I want to share some policies and provisions related to electric mobility in Nepal. The first is the Constitution of Nepal, Part 3, Section 30 of Nepal's constitution, right to clean and a healthy environment. It is the fundamental right of every Nepali citizen. So it is the guiding principle to go forward in electric mobility. Recently, we are going through 15th five-year plan, which is already in board. Chapter 8 of the 15th five-year plan deals with infrastructure, and section 8.1 is related to energy. One of the three objectives related to energy is to reduce the import of petroleum products. The working policy related to energy include fixing an appropriate tariff for EV and establishing charging stations for EV. Section 8.2 of the plan deals with transportation, under which section 8.2.1 focuses on roads, section 8.2.3 on railways, and section 8.2.5 on transport management. The vision for transport management is competitive, safe, and environment-friendly transportation system that are accessible for all. The strategy includes emphasize sustainable and environment-friendly transport system. Furthermore, the working policies include emphasize mass transit and bus rapid transit, and prioritize electric vehicles, and encourage local governments and cooperatives to invest in public transport and effectively regulate the private sector. The next policy is Kathmandu Valley Air Quality Management Action Plan 2020. The cabinet approved the Kathmandu Valley Air Quality Management Action Plan, which has listed promotion of electric vehicle as one of four measures to reduce vehicular pollution with following activities. Within 1 year, establish charging stations and bus terminals with charging facilities. Within 2 years, develop legal measures for the conversion of old vehicles to EV. Within 5 years, operate only zero emission vehicles in tourist and culturally sensitive areas. The next one is National Transport Policy 2001. List the following activities related to e-mobility, that is solar power and electricity driven transport means throughout the country. The next one is the custom and tax incentive to promote private sector, involvement in the construction, maintenance, and rehabilitation of transport infrastructure, and to encourage non-polluting vehicles. The next one is Environment-Friendly Vehicle and Transport Policy 2014. It has already mentioned that in 2020, we have to reach in 20% by 2020. It is already gone. Promote the conversion of other vehicles to EV and provide subsidies for the promotion of EVs. The improvement in transport practices and technologies. All these things are already mentioned in 2014 also. The next one is Environment Friendly Vehicle and Transport Policy 2014. The next National Action Plan for Electric Mobility 2018 aims to set a path of achievement of the electric mobility target adopted by the NDC, four key barriers, policy and governance, infrastructure and markets, financing and resources and data and monitoring. Three priority actions are establishing unit for electric mobility. For example, in MoPIT, we can establish a unit for facilitating the electric vehicles, national program for electric mobility, financing mechanism for electric mobility. The plan proposes a total of 24 initiatives, which are activities with limited scope and respond to address the identified barriers. Next one is Ministry of Energy, Water Resources and Irrigation's White Paper 2018 introduced appropriate policies and charging stations to increase the use of electric vehicles so that by 2023, half of the vehicles imported into the country are electric. Now I want to talk about the budget speech of 2021-22. By 2031, light vehicles petroleum will be replaced by electric vehicles. Converted vehicle to be exempted from annual vehicle tax and annual road maintenance cost for 5 years. Government of Nepal will operate at least 100 units of electric buses within Kathmandu Valley through PP. 500 charging stations will be set up within this fiscal year. Some fiscal incentives through budget 2021-22. There are some custom duties relaxation, road construction taxes, increase in road construction taxes. For example, 5% of the vehicle's price for four-wheeler CV up to 10%, or 10,000 for two-wheelers and three-wheelers electric vehicles, 15,000 to 1 lakhs for two-wheelers for other category of vehicles. There is VAT for all, 13% pollution taxes initially 0.5 rupees per liter of diesel petrol sold, but increased to Rs 1.5 in 2021-22. Infrastructure development taxes also there, 10 per liter diesel and petrol, road maintenance and improvement fee also there. Toll will be waived for 5 years for those converted EVs. Government will operate 100 big electric buses in Kathmandu Valley through PPP. These are some fiscal year budget address to promote the electric vehicles. Similarly, Bagmati Province Financial Act 2078 elaborates about the transport vehicle annual tax. Motorcycle up to 125cc to above 650cc, for example, 30,000. Electric motorcycle from 2,000 to 3,000. If it is petrol, diesel, it is 22,000 to 65,000. If it is electric vehicle, 15,000 to 30,000. Here I want to say about the Paris Agreement emission mechanism and implementation. 2020, the enhanced second NDC, 2021, COP26 Glasgow, 2023, global stock take stock of the implementation of Paris Agreement, including NDCs, to access the collective progress, 2025 updated new NDC outline and communicate climate action plans while enhancing the emission over time, 2028 global stock take, and 2030 updated new NDC, and 2050 the zero emission. This is the target. E-mobility components in Nepal's second NDC. As Bhushan ji told, sales of electric vehicles in 2025 will be 25% of all private passenger vehicle sales, including two-wheelers, and 20% of all four-wheelers public passenger vehicle sales. By 2030, increased sales of e-vehicles to cover 90% of all private passenger vehicle sales, including two-wheelers, and 60% of all four-wheelers public passenger vehicles sales. By 2030, develop 200 kilometers of the electric rail network to support public commuting and mass transportation of goods. Now I want to say where we have to go. First of all, we have to disseminate all the issues of electric vehicles with concerning stakeholders. The next one is awareness campaign among private and public vehicles owner, including two-wheelers also. And next one is cover all these electric vehicles policies in upcoming Vehicle Transport Management Act and regulation. These are the things which actually I want to share with you. Thank you.